As a kid, what was your worst shot? My parents are going to kill me moment? I tripped my little sister and she broke her arm. Amazing. She told everyone that she tripped over a stick, and she kept up the lie for 15 years, until we were both out of college. I think you owe her a life debt. When I was in elementary school, my sister and I were arguing once in a bathroom, at the sinks, and I leaned down to tie my shoe and she shoved my face down into the sink itself. Ended up busting my eyelid open. Dad had to come get me, and I ended up needing stitches. I'm 26 and still haven't ratted her out yet. She owes me a solid. You just told all of us, you snitch. Snitches got stitches. When I tried to throw a large stone over mom's car, I could not throw it over the car. I made a slingshot out of a piece of wood and some elastic. Thought I should test it out by shooting the back window of my parents' van. Slingshot worked. In 4th grade I drew some sexual scenes thinking I was the coolest kid in the world. I got caught by the teacher, so I ran toward the trash and threw the paper. The teacher ignored it, so I thought it was over. Later that day I'm in the teacher office, my dad was there, the drawing on the table. My life flashes before me. That one is going on the fridge. If my daughters ever do this, I will laminate it for future embarrassment. My dad bought me a car for my 18th birthday. Within the first month I accidentally scratched the side against an underground parking lot cement pole. I was so scared to tell my dad what I had done, but when I did his response was, well, that's why I bought you a shutty car, and that's the reason your first car should always be a shutty one. I cringe every time I see a kid pulling into a high school parking lot in a nice car. IDK if this counts for kid, but when I was 15 I took my dad's car at 3 a.m. to pick up this chick. When I got to her house I saw that my car had a flat tire. I called them, told them what I did and where I was, because I didn't really know how to drive and didn't want to drive on a flat. They were pissed. I'd say you deserve kudos for actually owning up though. When I was around 6 years old, the doctors had to have a pin put into one of my fingers to straighten it out. During school at lunch I pulled it out because I could. I soon realized I was ducked, and they had to put another back in when I was awake. When I was 5 years old, I jumped off a second floor balcony with an unfurled umbrella, hoping to fly like my hero Mary Poppins. But, of course, I didn't experience flight. I broke my ankle on impact, and ended the afternoon as a fat child weeping on the ground. You're the reason we have ridiculous warning labels. I got caught shoplifting when I was 13. Stealing video games. The worst part was that my dad worked for the railroad and was gone, so I had to wait over 24 hours for my punishment. My punishment was digging all the holes for fence posts around an acre and a half of land from sunrise to sunset. It took me most of my summer vacation, and I lost touch with a lot of friends because of it. When I was 13, I got a new laser pointer. I'd get bored and shine it in people's windows at night for just a second, just enough to mess with their heads. One night a cop showed up on my porch and threatened to take me to jail. My mother was not amused. Similar-ish story. In 2010 I was in China traveling with the school/city travel club. One friend of mine bought a very powerful laser pointer and was shining it out the hotel window for half an hour or so. Then three advisors showed up at our door saying that if we didn't cut that shut out the hotel staff was going to call the cops. We were young and took my GF's father's car for a spin into town. Avoided cops and had a great night. Rushed it back to the garage in time for the prefect crime. He walks in and we are all smug in the knowledge we had got away with something major. Until he asks why his car is wet when it's been garaged all night. I really thought we were in for it, but he laughed it off before pulling me aside and advising me if we ever did it again, he would have my balls as a hood ornament. When I was about 7 or 8 my mom worked at a dollar store run by my grandpa. It was in the next town over from where we lived, and so my mom would bring me to work with her. To pass the time I would play with random toys from the store. These toys included the lighter I managed to snag. I'd spend my days burning cardboard boxes out back and putting them out. You can imagine my terror when the store itself was lit up by a box I hadn't fully extinguished. TLDR, my career as a pyro ended in the 90s when I burned down a dollar store. I guess you could say your career was remove sunglasses, extinguished. I came home stoned as duck, and when I entered the kitchen I saw a bag of cookies one of my parents did for some friends. Being really hungry, I thought nobody would notice if I eat some of them. I accidentally destroyed the bag and half of the cookies landed on the ground. This happened 2 hours ago. I don't even have cookies in my house, but I'm stoned, and I'm afraid that this is gonna happen to me. I put a spoon in the microwave, a metal spoon. For 7 minutes I turned around from the couch and saw a fire in the microwave. What's the point if you don't watch the spoon? There is no spoon. I was cooking in our microwave. In my defense, it was an old microwave, and it suddenly started making weird crackling noises. I looked in, and the interior roof has a small fire right in the middle. So I did the only thing an 8-year-old would do. I yelled fire and sprinted out of the house and left my mum, who had to run out of the shower to put it out. I still do this when people ask me to make commitments. When I was in grade 8, this girl kept sending me love notes as a joke because her boyfriend thought it'd be funny for some stupid reason. Usually I just crumpled them up and threw them away, but one day I snapped and sent one back saying go suck on BF's name's balls. She saw it, laughed, and threw it on the ground. Of course the most hard-ass teacher finds that note and starts investigating about who wrote it. She found out it was me, just as school was over, so she told me to come see her the next morning. That was the worst 16 hours of my life. I just knew that she was going to yell until I started bleeding from my ears, then call my parents who would kill me right there and there. I went to school the next day, and turns out she forgot, and the girl stopped sending me notes too, so everything went better than expected. When I was about 10, I was playing with a friend who lived down the street. His younger brother and my younger sister both wanted to play hide and seek. We begrudgingly agreed and said we would be it first. We found this bucket of liquid and for some reason thought it was glue. It was at this point we decided to spread it all around the safe zone, thinking if we couldn't catch them, it would stop them, so we could tag them. It wasn't glue. It was some kind of solvent. My sister ran through it, slipped, and landed directly on her head. Blood and tears everywhere. Thought she was dead. Was convinced I was either going to jail or my parents would kill me. Turned out to be fine. Didn't even need stitches. Only grounded for like 2 weeks. Your sister literally got grounded. I lit a Mormon church dumpster on fire when I was 8 using a dried up palm tree branch. I ran away, but then came back to see if things got worse. The fire department and police were there along with a crowd, and a family that saw me do it and run away pointed me out to the cops. Never go back. Always a mistake. A. My parents were pretty tough on me. I never partied, drank, went out with friends, nothing. Grades were everything to my parents, and so was my getting into college. When I was a sophomore in high school, I thought I was going to get a C overall in biology, and I was freaking out about it for 2 weeks. I was going to bed crying every night because I was afraid of my parents' reaction. I finally told my mom that I thought my final grade was going to be a C before she could open my report card that we got in the mail. She said something like, "Well, I guess you can forget about college then." Turns out I got a B as a teen. I was surprised I got off so easy. No yelling or anything before the report card was opened. As an adult, I'm still pissed off by what she said. A C. Forget about law school. All you're good for is back alley prostitution now. A C. Might as well be a D, because that's all you'll be seeing while you're whoring yourself out because you couldn't get into a good school. Still am a kid, but in first grade I broke a spoon. I don't know why I was scared. We had a shut ton of spoons. My little 6-year-old brain couldn't imagine what would happen because I broke that ducking spoon. I thought I would have to run away or something. Turns out my parents didn't give a duck. Made phone calls to online sex story hotline. After finished listening, I heard another click on the phone of my mum hanging up. She was listening to me listening to online phone sex stories on the other line. Then at the end of the month, a $300 phone bill came. Edit, I was 11. For that kind of money, I hope it wasn't the only thing that came. When I was about 9 years old, my mom went out and left my sister and I at home with our dad. He was an extremely heavy sleeper, so whenever he was our sole guardian, we knew we had our run of the house after about 10 p.m. On this particular evening, my mom had left her Mac up on the bathroom counter. This was too tempting for me. I gathered my tools and went to work on my sleeping father. After a few minutes of carefully applying all of my 9-year-old boy Mac up expertise, I moved on and forgot about it. Fast forward. Apparently dad slept through his alarm the next day and rushed out of the house to work without stopping in the bathroom. Dad was a truck driver and not much of a fan of practical jokes. I can still remember when he got home. He opened the front door and just stared at me, not moving, not speaking. It was the one and only time growing up that I was genuinely afraid of my dad. I thought, shut, he's gonna kill me. TLDR, I put Mac up on my sleeping father. He woke up late and wore said Mac up to work. About 30 seconds after I came inside her, at age 13, without a condom. If she got pregnant, how the duck were you ducking at age 13? I lost my virginity at 13. All it takes is the right combination of hormones, a willing girlfriend that lives next door, and parents who are really deep sleepers. That's a very rare combination. When I was about 10 years old, it was a couple days before July 4th. So we had a bunch of fireworks sitting around. We had some piccolo pets, these horrible fireworks that just screech loudly for 10 seconds and do nothing else, and I took it in the backyard. Now about 10 minutes beforehand, my mom had told me not to light off any fireworks before the 4th. So I'm out there playing with my magnifying glass burning leaves and shut, and I decide to see if the magnifying glass can light a firework quick. But of course, I was going to stop it before it actually went off. So I see sparks flying, and I panic. I drop the magnifying glass and run inside where I meet face to face with my mom. She takes one look at me and says, "What did you do?" So I just stand there for a couple seconds sweating bullets, knowing what's about to happen. Then from the backyard you hear the unholy screeching of the firework begin to sound. You could see the look on her face slowly change from "I know you're up to something" to "you're a ducking idiot."